friends, and welcome back to the finals hall here at the 1972 Olympic Games shooting range for the first final of the day, 10-meter air pistol woman. I'm Hillary Russell and have the pleasure of having Serbia's 2010 world champion Zorana Arenovic here with me today. Welcome, Zorana, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me again.
You've got yourself all hooked up to some machine here. Tell us what's going on after your qualifications.
No, I have some back injury, which I'm treating with this small machine. So it's nothing serious. Mm-hmm. It used to be a little bit more serious, but now I'm fine. Thank you.
And so after every training and after every qualification, then you have to hook yourself up to this.
Yeah. It's basically just electricity going through my body, but it's nothing special.
So does it help to soften your muscles, or is
it just cramp prevention and relaxation?
Okay, all right. So we've got some new faces in this final today that we haven't seen before, but we've got a whole bunch of a lot of very experienced women. Tell us a little bit about this new finals format and what we should expect to see.
I don't think that I'm a really good person to talk about this new finals format because I'm not really a big fan of it. Mm-hmm. Basically 8 best shooters from qualifications qualify to the finals, and then everyone starts from the zero again. Mm-hmm. You have 2 stages. First stage is where shooters, athletes actually shoot 2 times 3 shots, and then they go advance to the second stage where they shoot shot per shot. And after each 2 shots, one of the shooters gets eliminated. Mm-hmm. Until you get medalists.
And who would you put your money on for today? I mean, it's really anybody's game. You come in, you don't have qualification scores, and you just go in.
I have no idea.
It's been down to the last shot for most of the finals this week.
I have no idea. You have new faces, you have young shooters, young successful shooters, you have experienced shooters, so I really don't know. I think I would put some more money on my teammates.
Of course. In fact, Yean entered in here in first place after qualifications.
Yes.
And you said that was a surprise.
Yes, it's not really a surprise, but for me, it is kind of, because I think that 25 meters is her better discipline, because she spends awfully lot of time doing 25 meters. I think we all do in Serbia. Mm-hmm. Because we don't have indoor range, so we need to use the weather conditions from April to August as much as possible. So we do 25 more. And I think that she's good in both disciplines, but this is kind of a surprise for me. But you can say, experienced shooter like that, she can always shoot good results.
Absolutely. So we're going to have a chance to introduce our 8 finalists today.
And the International Shooting Sport Federation welcome you to the Olympic Shooting Range Munich, the finals competition for the 10-meter.
So I'm firing point H, representing Belarus. We have Viktoria Chaika.
Chaika is actually one of the young, experienced shooters, and you can see her medals. So I think there is no point talking about her achievements. She's great.
On firing point G, representing Spain, we have Sonia Franquet.
Sonia Franquet, Spanish shooter. I remember her by entering the finals with me in World Championships in sport pistol, and I'm sorry that she wasn't able to win medal there, but hopefully she will win it now in air pistol.
On firing point F, representing Georgia, we have Nino Salukvadze.
Nino, what to say about her? She's one of 2 shooters who actually managed to get into second final in all 2 disciplines. One of the most experienced with Jasna and Munk, so we'll see.
On firing point E, representing France, we have Céline Gobreville.
Céline is one of the young but superior shooters, I think, in our generation. What can you say? She's Olympic vice champion, so she's one of the dangerous ones in the final.
On firing point D, representing Germany, we have Munkhbayar DORJSUREN.
Munk is same as Nino. Experienced, good, and dangerous.
On firing point C, representing Malaysia, we have Joseline CHEAH.
New face. Mm-hmm. New face with a very good result. And I think that because of that, she's in her first final, she can reach the medal.
And then on firing point B, representing India, we have Hina Sidhu.
Very good. She had 389 in the World Cup in Changwon. She wasn't able to reach the medal there, but I think it's possible for her to reach the medal now.
And on firing point A, representing your country, Serbia, we have Jasna Sekaric.
What can you say about shooting of millennium? What else can you say? Five-time Olympic medalist, my teammate. So yeah, she's my pick for today, as you can see.
Would you say that she's your mentor?
Yes. Well, you know, she used to be mentoring me a lot more before. When I was younger, she was actually pointing me to directions. She was giving me directions where to go, how to do trainings, you know, in those times that were basically really important for athlete that grows up. Mm-hmm. You know, and in times where I didn't have proper support, she was the one who had enough experience to tell me from her experience how to behave, what to do, how to pay attention, and on what to pay attention. So I'm really, really... Am I too loud?
Not at all.
Because people are...
It's fine. Just go right ahead.
She was the one who basically taught me many things, and I'm really grateful to her because of that.
You do have a good support system. You have your sisters, your coach, and
yes,
you have Jasna, who you've looked up to.
Yes, and I have also Bobana Veličković, mm-hmm, who is in team with us. She's double European champion in the last 3 years. And it's good that we have such a strong team because we can always compete between ourselves. Mm-hmm. It's never boring. It's always good to have such team with three good shooters that can basically compete between themselves. And we have training camps often together. So it's good. I think we're all three of us are very satisfied because of that.
So just keep in mind, we're going into the first of the series. They have 150 seconds to shoot three
shots. Yeah. Yes, which is basically pretty much enough. When you say 150 seconds, you think, oh, maybe it's not enough. Maybe we will need some more time, but basically it's really more than enough to fire three shots. Three good shots. Not to be in a hurry. And you see,
CHAIKA starting off with an 8.9. We're seeing a lot of shots in the eights, Sorana. What do you suppose is going on here?
Well, I would say maybe they are stressed out. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's the beginning. Usually the beginning is the hardest part of the final. And then when you get used to it, you know, after first one or two shots, then everything goes much smoother. But maybe it's the lights, but they had sighting series. They had sighting shots. So I think they adjusted their sights. I don't know, to be honest. As you can see now, I don't know what is the time, but Nino Silukvadze just fired her first shot.
Right. So it's 82, 81 seconds left.
Yeah. And you can see now, CHAIKA has 10.2, Sidhu has 10.1 after 8. Okay, Munk 9.8, but still. I think that the first shot is the one that carries the most of tension in your hand and in your head also. Mm-hmm. So after that first, I think after that first shot, everything is much easier. Maybe after second shot, but the first, I think, is the hardest.
But it's really important to start off strong because it's hard after these series. You know, you just have the single shots and, you know, one bad shot can send you right down into eighth place.
Yes, that's what I really don't like, because in qualifications you give your best, you know, you're maybe even, now you see the difference between the first and the fourth, 90 and 84, and you give your best during qualifications and you have such a big score, such an advantage, and then you go to final and you're all having the same result, same zero. And what you said, it's really important to start well.
So let's take a look here. After the first series, we have Franquette in first place, only by 1/10 of a point over CHAIKA and Salukvasi. Gaberville is in fourth place, only 2/10 of a point behind. CHAIKA had a perfect 10.9 to finish off the series, so that's a really great way to climb up the scoreboard.
Yeah, I could see Munk was expressing that she's not really satisfied with her performance. She had 8 and 2x9, but it's the beginning. Everything can happen in the next 3 shots or maybe next 5 shots. Everything is possible. But as you said, what I wanted to say is it's really important to start well, you know, mm-hmm, and to give your best in the beginning, because I tried, for example, to start like in medium way, not too hard, not too weak, you know, but and then to start chasing, but it's impossible. You lose.
Right.
You really need to start strong, and to give your best in the beginning, and then just to, how do you say,
to distance yourself.
Yes, to distance yourself, then everyone, and then just to keep your distance. You know, it's easy then.
So DORJSUREN is starting off with a 10.3. That's more like her shooting.
No, in this round only one time nine.
Back on now to CHAIKA.
As you can see what's going on with Indian shooter, I think that this situation was the same as in Korea. She also had the qualification score of 389, but in the finals, I think in the beginning, that she didn't start it so well, and I think she was out on the sixth or fifth place, something like that. Really fast, according to comparing to the result that she had in qualifications. Now it's really hard to understand that qualifications where you were actually struggling with yourself for 50 minutes don't mean anything. Mm-hmm. They just have no importance anymore. I think that's one of the hardest parts for each athlete now, just to understand and to accept that qualifications have absolutely no importance now.
Okay, Gabarvi, she has just finished off the second series. And she's moving up the scoreboard.
And now you see CHAIKA. She started with an 8, and now she's leading.
Sidhu finishing off with a 9.5.
Stop.
Okay, so after the second series, after 6 shots, we have CHAIKA holding on to first place now by 1/10 of a point. Galbraith has moved up the scoreboard. She is holding on to second place by 0.5 point. So Lukvitsi is in third place, and Franquette is in fourth, only by 3/10 of a point. It's a really, really tight match right now.
Yeah.
We've got to keep an eye on eighth place, because after the second single shot going on now, the first of the athletes will be eliminated. And right now, Hina Sidhu from India is in the hot seat, but she's only 2/10 of a point behind Sekarich. And I mean,
and she's 2/10 of a point behind Malaysian shooter.
Exactly.
In this final. Yeah, it's tight. You know, there is no bigger advantage anywhere in any place, you see, in any position. So basically these two shots will give us some more clue what's going on, and maybe someone will just dislocate from the group.
Let's focus in now on Gabriel, who's currently in second place.
Yeah, she's holding her pistol not so steady. Uh-oh, I think it's too...
8.8.
Yeah, she was holding it for too long. And you can see she missed the time to fire a shot, so...
Stop.
So at the moment now we have CHAIKA in first place by 1.1/10 of a point over Franquette. Gabarvi is now in third place, 3/10 of a point behind Franquette. And we've got a tie for fourth place between CHEAH and DORJSUREN. Holding on to eighth place is Sidhu, 1.2/10 of a point behind Sekarich. Anything can happen. We've just seen, you know, some shots in the eight. So,
but to be honest, I expected a bit, well, how to say. Better result in the final, to be honest. I mean, you see the qualification scores from 90 to 84. It's, well, in World Cup in Munich, you always have really, really good scores in air pistol, in indoor, because, and I was really expecting some bigger scores in the final, but I don't know what's going on.
Waiting
far
now
shots.
On to Sekarich.
Not many inner tens. Oh, come on. Oh.
9.4 for Sidhu. And Sekarich has got 11 seconds now.
Ugh.
Oh, 8.8.
It always happens, you know, when you have 50 seconds to fire a shot, if you need to prepare yourself to just fire it from the first time, just to release it from the first time, because if you're not sure that it's good, and if you put it down, you won't have enough time to do it again in the proper way, as you can see.
So as you can see, we're going to have to say goodbye to Hina Sidhu from India. CHAIKA is holding on to first place by 1.1 tenth of a point, and we've got a tie between DORJSUREN and Gabaville for second place. 9 tenths of a point behind is Franquette.
Next competition shot, low.
We've got Sekaritu is in the hot seat right now, 8 tenths of a point behind Saluk Vidze.
But you see, the difference is only 0.8, 0.1, 0.3, so...
It's anybody's.
Basically, yeah.
Again, back on now to Saluk Vidze.
But look at the screens. Look at their groups. Mm-hmm. You can see that they are really struggling. And I think that they are nervous, all of them.
And Sekaritu to the 9.4.
Okay, I think this made her not so close to moving to next level, moving to next stage.
So we've got CHAIKA in first place by a point and a half over DORJSUREN. Franquette is in third place, only 6 tenths of a point, and tied up with Gabaville. Sekaritu has got to really shoot strong right now in order to not be eliminated after this next shot.
Well, only as you can see from the first nine shots. Sorry, mm-hmm. My treatment is done. As you can see, only CHAIKA has like really not so good score, but average score for mm-hmm. for a pistol shooter. And can you imagine how wonderful it would be if she didn't score the first shot 8?
Yeah,
it would be so much better. But she kept strong. She went strong to get some good tens.
Sekaritu with a 10.4. Unfortunately, it's not enough to keep her in the game.
We're going I lost to have my to money.
Okay, now we've got Zorana, who is poor. No more money. And we're going to have to say goodbye, unfortunately, to Yean Sekaritu from Serbia. We have CHAIKA still in first place by a point and a half. Gabavi in second place, holding on to that by a half a point over CHEAH. DORJSUREN has moved down into fourth place, but she's only 2 tenths of a point behind CHEAH.
Malaysian shooter is holding on well.
She really is.
I am happy to see that. You know, it's always nice to see when someone who is she's not a new face, but new face in the finals, you know?
Yeah.
And you have a new face, and it goes... For the medal,
mm-hmm.
and that's always wonderful to see. It always happens to, well, not always, but it usually happens with Chinese shooters.
Exactly.
You know, as we spoke about it in 25 meter finals, Chinese shooters always bring some new faces that comes to first time to the World Cup, enter for the first time in the final, and for the first time win gold
medal.
Yeah.
And then we don't see them again. You know, it's amazing. We have these athletes' profiles, and half the time they don't even have a photo on it. So.
Yeah.
This is how new they are to the circuit, international circuit. DORJSUREN, a 10.1.
Okay. Malaysian shooter is climbing.
She certainly is. She's climbing up the leaderboard without a doubt. We've got Franquette, who is in sixth place right now, only 4 tenths of a point away from Salupati. We have CHAIKA holding on to first place by 1.3 tenths of a point over CHEAH.
Very, very close, though, behind Joseline CHEAH, only 0.3. between her and Munkhbayar DORJSUREN.
So this is going to be the deciding shot. What do you think, Zorana?
I have no idea.
I know, it's too close to even.
I would put my money on Nino.
Stop.
She would advance to the next stage. But again, I lost all my money, so.
Okay, let's take a look at these two women, Franquette and Saluk Vidze.
Look at CHAIKA.
10.8 for Saluk Vidze.
This is, as I told you, I don't have money, but...
Now this is getting very, very interesting because we have got Franquette, who has finished off with a 9.5, and that's not enough to save her. We're going to have to say goodbye to Sonia Franquette from Spain. And
And now,
with that beautiful 10.8 from Salupazi, she has moved up now into second place.
But I wanted to say, and now when everyone is giving applause to Sonia Franquet, she's putting the safety flag, which I don't think it's very good for the audience. Like, really, whenever something like that happens, when they are announcing who is leaving the finals, spectators are applauding and we are putting safety flags. So not even turning to the audience, you cannot go and wave and say thank you, but you are putting safety flag inside.
This is going to determine fifth place. We have Gabarvi, who is in fifth place at the moment by 0.8 of a point behind Dursarin. Shaika still, she's making her advance. She's 2.2 of a point now.
Oh,
ahead.
Wonderful.
Wow, 10.8 for Gabarville.
Oof.
9.5 for Dorsaren.
And you see now, from the second place, she fell into fifth place, and that's only one shot.
One shot brings her right down the scoreboard, and that has to do with CHEAH. Let's take a look here. Shaika still holding on to first place by 2.3 of a point, and we have Gabarvi and Salukvitsi tied up for second place. Dorsaren is in fourth place, and CHEAH is 0.6 of a point behind.
And as we said, everything can happen in just one shot.
Mm-hmm. But it looks like Shaika, she's shooting a good final.
I think that she had that little crisis in the beginning, as I told you. Three of them shot 8, and I think it's normal in the beginning that you have weaker shots, but not really an 8, but hey, it's okay. But as you can see now, she's really in the proper mood and into the proper rhythm, and she will have a great finals until the end.
We have CHEAH with a 9.7 finishing off, waiting now for Dorsaren. With a 9.7, which is enough to stay in the game.
Nino is aiming too long.
Yes, 8.1, and actually things changed around on that 8.1. Thought we were going to have to say goodbye to CHEAH, but in fact we're going to have to say goodbye to Nino Salukvitsi from Georgia,
who is putting the safety flag.
Okay, we're going to be going for our fourth place now. The high score of the round was Viktoria Chaika with a 10.4. Now you can call it, Zorana. You're taking a look and seeing how long she's holding it, and you knew that it was not going to be a good shot.
Yes, well, basically you can hear where, at what time do athletes fire, you know. You can hear when someone is holding it too. You can actually hear when not all of them fire the shot. And you see and you know when someone is holding for too long, and the longer you hold, the less chance you have to score a good shot.
Let's focus in now on CHEAH. She's holding on to fourth place by a half a point. And
she has a big movement on her pistol, but
it's a 10.7, unbelievable shot.
To shoot well.
And that is exactly what you have to do to stay in the game. She is now tied up with Gabarvi. Shaika is holding on to first. She's got a solid 3-point lead over Dorsaren. And a tie between CHEAH and Gabarville, only 0.3 of a point behind Dorsaren. And this is going to be the very, very important shot.
All three of them are in hot seat at the moment, in my opinion. So we'll see what happens. And all of them are capable of having a good and not so good shot.
Exactly. Currently tied up for third place. This is probably the most important two shots, because this is when we go into medals after these two shots. And a 9.4.
10.2 and 10.
A 7.8 for Gabarvi.
Oh. What happened?
Stop. Yikes.
So, ladies and gentlemen.
So we have medalists.
We are going to have to say goodbye to Celine Gabarvi from France with that 7.8 that knocked her right down. We are going to be going now for the medals, and we've got Shaika, Dorsaren, and CHEAH. CHEAH is 1.3 of a point behind Dorsaren.
I'm
this is going to be going for the bronze.
I'm happy that new face,
right?
Actually wins medal.
It's the first time that she's entered into a final round of a World Cup before, so it's a huge accomplishment.
Yes. Imagine if she wins medal. I mean, she won medal.
She did win a medal. I don't have to imagine that. She has. Only 1.3 tenths of a point. We have CHEAH behind DORJSUREN.
I think that there is no problem for CHAIKA to win gold.
No.
No one can actually jeopardize her first place. But now let's see what happens for gold.
10.6 for CHEAH.
Okay.
Oh. Come unbelievable. On. A 7.2 for DORJSUREN. And that's my God, what's...
But look at D, E, and F. 7.2, 7.8, and 8.1.
My gosh. She is shooting the highest point at this point. It's at 10.6. We've got one more shot to go to find out who is going to be going home with the bronze with that DORJSUREN shooting that 7.2. She just, you know, fell down 2.1 tenths of a point. And then is in third place, but anything can happen.
Yeah, things like this happen.
Yeah,
you know, when is the final, when you're shooting the final, stress is much more intense than in qualifications, and basically you do things that you maybe, or 99.9% you wouldn't do in qualification round. So, it happens.
Let's focus in now on CHEAH. 10.7, unbelievable.
Oh, look.
And a 9.7 for DORJSUREN. That is going to get her on the podium. She's going to be going home with a bronze medal. I'm sure she'll be kicking herself for that 7 points.
Ah,
she
she's
had,
waving.
There she is.
Safety flag.
You can Munkhbayar, DORJSUREN.
You can choose whether to wave or put
I say wave. We have CHEAH, who shot a beautiful 10.7. She's 1.8 tenths of a point now behind CHAIKA.
She did use the advantage that CHAIKA has.
Yes.
Which I thought it's impossible.
Right. Now we're finding that it is very possible.
Yes.
If she overtakes...
I lost money. First thing, I lost money.
You had to commentate while you're hooked up to a machine putting electricity through your body. It's been a day. Okay, let's take a look here on for CHEAH.
She looks, you see, she looks very confident.
She does. 10.6 for both of them.
Wow.
So things have not changed around at all.
And
both of them with a 10.6.
Now you see, this is, I think that the last shot is more most intense shot of the final. So in this shot, for some reason, you know, you have advantage. And then you're struggling so hard because in your last shot, just to keep the advantage, so basically everything can happen now.
That's right.
Like on any previous shot, everything can happen.
All right, this is the shot for the gold between CHEAH and CHAIKA. Like you're just saying, Zorana, anything can happen. Let's see if CHAIKA can keep
I
up her lead.
It's 20th time we said anything can happen.
I know. Well, things are happening.
Oh, so she's aiming. Oh.
9.0.
It's okay. So May 10.8. No.
9.0. Unbelievable. Both of them having
same
the same
shots
on both of them. Oh, dear. So let's take a look and see where we can see our gold medalist today. From Belarus, we have Viktoria CHAIKA, who is our gold medalist today. There she is, shooting a great final. She really stayed in the lead, didn't let her guard down.
Oh, look. How a Malaysian shooter is actually so happy. You know, you don't see that much
That's
of
right.
happiness with shooters. We are used to fighting emotions.
There she is, Joseline. CHEAH from Malaysia winning the silver medal, doing a great job. She climbed up the scoreboard, and she'll be on the podium today.
Wonderful.
Zorana, thank you so much for joining me today. I really look forward to seeing you in Granada. You'll be there?
Yes.
Yes. And I'll plan on doing a gold medal interview with you. Okay?
Yeah, I
no
hope.
Pressure.
I hope. not taken.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
So we have a lost video camera.
anybody has lost such an item. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the medal ceremony for the 10-meter air pistol women's event will now take place. The medals will be presented by Mr. Wolfgang Kiel, President of the Bavarian Sport Shooting Federation and first Vice President of the German Shooting Federation. Your bronze medalist, representing Germany, Munkhbayar DORJSUREN. Your silver medalist, representing Malaysia, Joseline, CHEAH. And your gold medalist, representing Belarus, Viktoria, CHAIKA. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Belarus.